welcome back, or welcome for the first time, to TM1 Bytes Weekend Edition. We are in the race session for race 10 at Vancouver. And for those of you who missed the practice and quali sessions, which does have the lowest viewership of the three episodes, so there may well be quite a few of you, I draw your attention to this. No, you are not seeing things. No, I have not fabricated this screenshot in Photoshop. That is what actually happened. How it happened, I am still at a loss to explain. I suspect that the suspension has something to do with it. Yes, we are still seventh in suspension, but that's as a team. And obviously, little Max's suspension is a lot better than Snidely's. And of course, suspension is critical on this track. Other than that, I think we just got lucky. So hopefully, the luck will continue. Let's take a look at the splash screen on the cars. As we can see, that suspension of Little Max has gone up to 619. That's the level 5 one that we just built. 95% reliability, which will be fine, even though it's a critical part. That means that Snidely has inherited Little Max's old one, 547 out of 584. We'll get that up to spec as quickly as we can. Still a pretty fair gap between 547 and 619. So although we might be 7th overall, doesn't necessarily mean that Little Max is 7th on the grid in respect of that. Little Max is 22.76% better than he was at the start of the year. Snidely, unfortunately, only 10.34. Snidely did not do so well. He came in 14th, although that is his best position for a while. Some of the other ones are a little bit surprising. So we can see that Hamilton, for example, who is usually somewhere in the top 5, is currently in 12th. Yeah, so that's a little bit surprising. Not that many other surprises, I suppose. Bergman's come back to form a little bit, 15th last time. So, yeah, there's been a little bit of a switch up. All right, this is annoying. Apparently, the recorder must have been on pause for a whole bunch of stuff, as a result of which it didn't get recorded, and as a result of which some of the things that I say later in this episode don't make any sense unless you know what I talked about here. I wanted to find out exactly what the performance difference is between Supersofts and Ultrasofts, okay? Because I wanted to find out what the best strategy would be for Little Max in this race. Now, there are problems with trying to work out the actual difference in performance between the two tyre types. You can't effectively do it in practice or in qualifying, for reasons that I won't go into here because it'll make the episode too long. But in this case, Little Max on pole with first lap hero, you would think he'd be able to hold first position all the way through that lap. Traffic would therefore not be an issue, and we would get some clear idea of, well, we know which tyre will be faster, but by how much? Guess what? It didn't happen. Take a look at this chart. Little Max's best time was in fact on Supersofts. And in most cases, he did not hold first position, bringing traffic into the equation. So, all we can say is that if you have an ideal, theoretical set of circumstances, Ultrasofts will be faster than Supersofts. We know that. We don't know by how much. We still don't know by how much. So, this is the strategy that I decided to adopt, and that was the set of tests that I talk about later in the episode. If Little Max is going to get the best, fastest lap, it's going to be near the end when there is a lot of rubber on the track. And he's probably going to need Ultrasofts to do it, but if he has the Ultrasofts, then he's not going to have the Supersoft performance bonus. Alternatively, if we give him the Ultrasoft performance bonus, he's not going to have the Supersoft performance bonus during the bulk of the race, which we're going to need to do the bulk of it on Supersofts to make sure that we can cover that distance. We could theoretically do two Ultrasoft stints and one Supersoft stint, but I think we'd probably be better off keeping the tyres fresher for longer, and that means going out on Supersofts. That's why I wanted to know how much of a difference that makes. That was why it became really important at this point. What I'm going to do is put Little Max out for two stints on Supersofts of 10 each, and then put him onto an 8-lap stint for Ultrasofts right at the end when the rubber is high. Snidely, I'm not going to bother about that because he might as well just have the bonuses all the way through, so I'm going to put him out on Supersofts all the way through with the Supersoft bonus. So, Little Max, you are going to have race trim, obviously, and I'm going to give you the bonus still on Supersoft tyres because you'll be doing the overwhelming majority of your race on Supersofts. Snidely, you are going to have the bonus on Supersoft tyres and you're going to have the race trim as well. Confirm that. Car setup, we did okay-ish. tyre choice is going to be super softs for these first stints. I'm not going to take any fuel out. I'm getting to the stage where I'm half tempted to do it. I'm going to leave that as it is. And Snidely is going to be exactly the same. And tyre choice will be super soft. Fuel options, we're going to do exactly the same thing. Driver strategy is obviously going to be hot in the city for little Max, because first lap hero and everything. Not, we saw that it did him a lot of good in all cases last time. We'll get Snidely to push the tyres up. The temperature is actually 17 degrees, which is pretty comfortable. What I need to remember to do here, and I'm just concerned that I'm going to get caught up in the race and forget to do it, is watch that weather, because there is still a 40% chance of rain forecast for this race. We don't know what's coming up. Everybody happy? Let's rock. There's the grid which I told you about before. So like I said, Jens Bergman's made a pretty spectacular comeback. He has lifted himself back up to the lead. Batista and Flores, you kind of expect them to be up the front somewhere. Costa, Mikhailovich, Brownlee, we're starting to see the usual pattern down here, except for Zach Hamilton. It is really surprising to see Zach Hamilton way back in 12, but he's got an estimated form of 1, so he's not in a happy mood. Snidely has only got 3, but like I said, like I have said in the past, these estimated form numbers are usually rubbish anyway. They never come anywhere near what the reality of it is. So Snidely's up 2 positions on his usual place, which is now taken over by Falco, Ollie Clark-Smith, Masalella, Kranz. Bobby Stone Jr., I don't think is normally that far back. Garuda's not doing well this year, but he's not normally right on the last row, so he did not have a happy qualifying weekend. Let's go. Most of the front runners are going out on ultra softs. Little Max is still holding his position, but he's only got 0.1 as a buffer, 0.2 now. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. When he held his first position when I was doing those tests, he usually was holding it by, well, we're up to 0.4 now, but those first ones when he was on ultra soft, I kind of expected that. So he's doing pretty decently at the moment. Yeah, 0.4. Once I take him off that cooking mode, he's liable to lose a bit. Alright, so we've got to make those tyres last for 10 laps. I don't think you'll have any problems doing that. Got a high push. Snidely, your tyre temps are pretty much up to neutral, so go to high neutral on that. That'll make your tyres last. And bringing you in on 9, I could probably actually get you to push your tyres up a little bit further. I'm still concerned about, what the hell's that? Can't get past Batista. Oh, great, you've lost first. That's not totally surprising because, I mean, he is on a slower set of tyres and he may well lose second. Bergman is obviously out there on ultra softs and Blanc is really pushing him as well. Those two bluish-purplish cars there. What mode are they on, just out of curiosity? They are... Okay, they're hammering their engines, but they're a little bit slower than... Alright, what's the park condition like? Park condition should not be a problem at this point. So, okay, Porter's falling back. I don't really want that. Get up to overtake mode. Snidely, you can get up to overtake mode as well, because we're stacked up with fuel. Our part reliability is pretty good at this time of the year, so let's see what you can do. I don't fancy Snidely's chances against Falco at the moment, simply because of the tyre difference. So, Snidely's last lap was 1:15.091, and Falco's 1:14. Alright, I'm going to go up to 2 times. Porter's dropped all the way back to 7th, that's not good. Everybody is on the maximum engine mode at the moment. So they're all on overtake, so there's no real benefit to be gained. Little Max is the only one who is on push on his tyres, and his temperatures are getting up to the extent that I'm going to have to bring him back. On the other hand, Snidely's are starting to cool down a little bit by the looks of it. So I'm pretty sure they were almost level at one point. We have noticed before that Little Max somehow does cause his tyres to heat more than Snidely does. So Little Max is now in 7th. All of the ones ahead of him are on ultra soft, so I'm not unduly worried about that. Damn it, can't get past Flores. Don't worry about it. Early days yet. So, lap 9 is when Snidely is coming in. Should we go up to 4 times? Let's leave it on 2 times for the moment. Okay, so 113, 816. So he's slower than the ones in front of him. Been 2 laps like this. Yeah, well, just don't stack it into anything. Bide your time and jump him when the iron is hot. 113, 712. He's still going slower than the ultra soft brigades. But it also depends on what the ultra soft brigades are going to do. So if Batista, for example, is trying to go and do the entire race on ultra softs, then she's going to be doing 3 pit stops. And that's where Little Max is going to get an advantage. We're on lap 7. We have 2 laps to go. My God, look at that gap up front between Batista and Daylight. 8.5 seconds. That is remarkable. Little Max has pushed his way up to 6th. Clark Smith is in the pits. Blanc has pitted as well. So that would be the other one. They're both coming out on super softs. I don't know if anybody's going to be unwise enough to try to do the entire race on ultra softs. We shall see. Bergman's in the pits. Right, we're on lap 9. Let's get back to 1 time. Snidely, you are on lap 9, aren't you? You are on lap 9. All right, pit. Okay, so you are going to be going out on a fresh set of super softs. Your fuel options are going to be... I'm going to give you 12, so you will actually have 12. I'm just going to make a change there, just so that it triggers the fuel at pit stop. Otherwise, they probably would have left him with just 11.45 and not done a refueling at all. Park condition is not bad. Rear wing is starting to suffer a little bit. That's not surprising because the rear wing, obviously, we do not have that up to 100%, and it is a critical part on this occasion. Balance pit stop will be fine. We'll be coming out in 16th. We can live with that. Okay, coming in. His tyre temps are starting to get up a little bit now, but I'm not going to take him down. There's no point in taking him down. But, oh, there is a point in taking him down, but not yet. Little Max has made his way back up to 4th, but that's mostly as a result of pitting. Yeah, I can see your temperatures, Little Max. Don't worry about it. Alright, so I'm going to bring him to high neutral because that's the way I want him coming out. Come on. Jack's okay, wheel's okay. Refueling was excellent. Alright, Little Max, it is time for you to pit. You are on lap 10, you are in the lead again. You are in lap 10, yes you are. Pit, okay, so come on in. You will get a fresh set of super softs. Your fueling will be 12 laps to do 10. So, not that much. Right, 11.65 will give you 12. Your park condition is okay-ish. Yeah, there's nothing horrible there. Okay, so bring it in, and you're expected to come out in 11th position. Alright, so Navarro is the only one who is out on ultra softs after a change. Flores as well, also Batista. Batista was on ultra softs originally, so this is her second stint on ultra softs. That's interesting. Alright, Little Max. Fueling's okay. Right, now I want you back on high engine mode. Oh, for God's sake, Leonardi! That means that Leonardi's going to be out for 3 weeks until the last race, probably. And that is our strong suit. The Jacks are where we were really good, mostly because of Leonardi, except that Leonardi screwed up and now we don't have a decent Jack crew for the next 3 races. All right, Navarro. Batista is really making her way back up. Parks is going to have to pit and is pitting. Mikhailovich, ditto. Stone Jr., ditto. And also, who's the fourth one in there? Somebody else has gone in, but they keep dropping. I think it's Shah. Yeah, Shah. All right, so Tyre temps are okay. Weather is looking sunny all the way through. There's a little bit of cloud at the end of that, but it doesn't look like rain, I don't think. Temperature is at 17, dipped by 1 degree there briefly, but that's okay. That's not really a harbinger of anything. Fuel is looking good. Snidely's next pit stop is going to be on 19. Little Max is on 20. So which lap is Snidely on at the moment? We're so focused on Porter. There's Snidely. All right, it's made its way back up to 10th. That's not so bad. That's not so bad at all. All right, looking at the tyre usage on the Ultra Softs, Batista has obviously burnt through that at a prodigious rate of knots. The track grip is coming up, and it's really going to start accelerating, provided there's no rain, it's going to start accelerating by the time we hit lap 21, and that's going to be perfect for us because that's when Little Max is going to make his assault. Let's get across to Little Max and see what he's doing. Okay, let's zoom out a little bit and see a bigger picture. All right, so Little Max, there's a heck of a distance between Blanc and Little Max. It's 3.3 seconds. So he's not doing exceptionally well in keeping up with Blanc. And that's surprising because Blanc. Details, standings, tyre usage. All right, so Blanc started out on Ultras. Are we going to be okay with these fuel levels? You should be. 14 of 28. You're 6 points. You're coming in on 19. You're fine. Don't distract me. I'm busy. All right. So, Blanc, we were looking at his tyre usage. So he's done 7 on Ultra Softs, 7 on Super Softs. Huh. Okay. So he's actually doing... he's doing massively well on those super softs. Mind you, Porter's not far behind. I mean, he's 3.4 seconds behind, but overall, he's holding his position pretty decently. Now, we are amongst the few burning through the fuel, and I'm okay with that. Everybody's done one pit stop. Everybody's keeping their tyres relatively neutral. Tyre temps are okay. With only 3 laps to go, though, I might start pushing Snidely up a little bit. Because we might as well try and make up a little bit of ground here. And in fact, Little Max, which lap are you on? You're on 16. You're coming in on 20. You can push your tyres up a little bit too, because your tyre temps are nowhere near a problem. That might give us a slight edge. It might give Snidely enough of an edge to take out Hamilton. There's 6.28... and his last lap was slower. Let's get up to 2 times and see what happens when he crosses the line here. The Snidely's in 12th at the moment. Right, 1:14.604. Oh, he's actually, everything's changed anyway. Brownlee is in front of him. Brownlee is doing much better time. Hamilton is actually still doing a better time, 1:14.287. 1:14.287. Yeah, Crowley has crashed. Crowley has crashed. When did that happen? Obviously, stuff happens when I'm not noticing it. Okay, so that doesn't necessarily help us because where we need to be is above that green bar. I'm not really worried about picking up 17th or 18th place. Okay, Clark Smith is in the pits. He's done 2. Blanc is in there for 2. Lap 18 of 28. All right, Snidely's just gotten past Stone Jr. and then Costa just got past him. We got 3 in the pits at the moment. Flores and God almighty, we've got a hell of a lot in the pits at the moment, but they keep bouncing around so I can't see clearly who it is. Okay, so as soon as I look over here and then look over there, then by that time the name's changed somewhere. Can we pit for fresh tyres soon? Matter of fact, Snide, you are reading my mind on that one. So, you are coming in on 19, I hope. You are coming in on 19, yes. All right, I didn't catch what Little Max said there because I was looking at the pit lap plan. All right, so you're going to be going out for a last stint on that, and you are going to be damn near down to vapor on fuel, so that's worked perfectly. Okay, so we are going out with 10 laps for you, my friend. Actually, rear wing's a little bit dodgy, but everything else is looking good. I think I shall give you 11 laps to do that 8 laps, and that way you can start hammering it home. You'll be a little bit heavy to start out with, but we can send you out fast to start out with. Your park condition should hold up. All right, get in here, Snide. And in fact, no, don't push up your engine mode because you... Oh, okay, you're already in. Jack's okay. Refueling could be better. All right, so I'm going to push you back to... Okay, push high will be fine. All right, little Max. His tyre temps are feeling really high. Yeah, okay, bring him back. But on the other hand, you are on lap 20. Oh my God, no. Oh, crud. We just missed the pit. Okay, fuel options, you are going to be... It's the first time that's happened in ages. That's because I was concentrating on Snide. Ah, 8 laps remaining. You'll have 10 to do. I'll give you 11. Okay, park condition is okay-ish. Your engine is actually starting to get a little bit dodgy. All right, pit. And I think it's actually too late now, so I'm going to bring you back off that because you're on low fuel at the moment. You should be alright on medium. No point pushing up your tyres because you're damn near pegging at the moment. You should be alright on your fuel level. Damn. 18. Who's in the pits? Massalella and Clark Smith are both in with mechanical issues. Hurry it up, little Max. Front jack, wheels, fuel. Now, this is going to be a little bit risky because your engine's looking a little bit dodgy, but it's not looking so dodgy that I'm worried about doing it. Go, 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 go. Tire temps, we're going to have to keep an eye on because those might get a little bit iffy. No sign of rain out to the end of the race. Nope, that's just cloud. All right. Tire temps on Snide are coming up a little bit faster than I would like. So I might pull him back to neutral so that he can conserve those for later. But I'm going to push him up into overtake mode because his... What's that? Can't get past Margate. We'll try it now. Your parts are looking all right. Suspension's looking a little bit dodgy. Now, you should be all right. We're 23 out of 28. So we're really going to start pushing it. Now, little Max's tyre temps are already starting to come up into the red zone. Little Max is in fourth. If he can hold that, we should have some nice points. Now, I'm going to bring him back to neutral on that. He's 5 seconds behind the car in front of him, 5.2, and about 2 seconds ahead of the car behind him. So he's green in both directions. I don't think at this stage he can make up the distance to Blanc. I doubt that any of those three are going to come into the pits at this point. So I don't think we'll get a podium unless somebody's got some dodgy parts on board and they get caught in scrutineering. Snidely. Okay, his tyre temps are starting to come down a little bit now. All right, so Bergman behind is on super softs. He shouldn't change the strategy to get past Margate. All right, your tyre temps are coming down. Push them up a little bit. Little Max, your tyre temps are coming up even though you're on neutral. So I'll push you up maybe next lap. You got past Batista. How the hell did you... Whoa, hang on. What happened there? You've gotten up into second because Blanc and Batista are pitting. Batista's pitting with mechanical troubles. Really did not see that coming because they should have been able to stretch those tires out for the rest of the time. He's up now in second. He's 6 seconds off Flores. He's not going to catch Flores. But I think we might just have ourselves a podium, people. All right, so Snidely's tyres are almost pegging, but they're on the last lap. Okay, come back to high mode because you're running low on fuel there, Snide. Actually, come back to medium mode because you're really running low on fuel. So I don't want you running out of fuel there. And in fact, bring that back as well. There's no point. Porter, on the other hand, has got plenty of fuel, and he's coming across the line in second! Good job today, everybody. Nice result. Damn straight. All right, so Snidely, can you... No, you're 3 seconds out. 10th was pretty good. 10th was pretty good. Only bad thing about that race was me missing Little Max's pit. But it turned out okay. I'm really surprised that those ones ahead of him pitted when they did. Really surprised. We have got that setting about the more realistic pit stops. So, I don't know. I still would have regarded that as being a mistake. He was running fourth up until there. Who was that ahead of him? Batista and Blanc. So Batista really trashed the chances. She went straight down to 15th after the pit stop. Blanc didn't suffer as much damage. He came back to be 5th. Batista, I think, did have mechanical problems, but even so, there was just no reason to come in as a result of the tyres. There had to be some other motivating factor, because the cliff number on Supersofts is such that that's plenty of rubber to see out another 2 laps. Yeah, it would have to have been something really critical mechanically, because she did have the mechanical indicator on. Otherwise, that was a bad mistake on the part of the pit crew. Or, not on the part of the pit crew, but whoever made the decision to come in. Continue. And somebody got pinged. That was a 10-second penalty for Navarro. I'm not sure what for, but unless he was the one who caused the crash that took out Crowley. 10-second penalty on Winston Margate as well, so not so good for him. But the point is, Zach Hamilton took out the fastest lap bonus, which is the reason that I was pushing Little Max out on the Ultrasofts towards the end. I wanted him to get that, but was not to be. Was not to be, but still he got 2 points. So that wasn't bad. That wasn't bad at all. Yeah. Okay, continue on. Max Porter second. Okay, Lucia Flores first. We're getting used to that. Rosado Corsa first and third. They are pretty much certainly going to take out the championship this year. All right, so Little Max has gotten himself up to third. 32 points, 44 behind Flores with 3 races to go. I would say the chances are pretty much Buckley's and none, but he might be able to push up to overtake Zach Hamilton. And the team standings, we are holding at third. Just thinking about MRT Valbuena makes me angry. No class at all. Theodore, take it down a notch, man. Chill. Jonas Brownlee told me that there's not enough investment in the car from Ruiz Motorsport. Interesting. Okay, Boateng has such an awesome helmet. Clearly helps good that Ea Quantistic get a few points today. All of the points were gained by Little Max, not by Snidely. Okay, Max Porter finished in second place. Hamilton taking the final podium spot. Okay, let's continue on. Snidely had a driver form of 7.0. Continue. We made 1.029 million. This is the kind of money making that I like to see. This is the kind of money making that I like to see too. Thomas, we are finally in agreement on something. All right. 17 days to Munich, where it's likely to be raining. I do not fear the rain. I do fear not knowing what the rain is going to do. And that means forecasting center. You know it, and I know it. If you enjoyed this episode, it would be greatly appreciated if you'd whack the like button over the head, subscribe if you'd like to do so, comment if you would like to do so. In the meantime, I hope you have a very good week, and until next week, goodbye.